morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Okay. Beautiful day out there, isn't it?
Right.
Okay. Just like to share with you and welcome you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, and welcome those who are watching us here on Facebook and YouTube this morning. And so one announcement I have down here is that next Sunday will be the first Sunday. Lighting the candles. You will be honored to have a brother, Reverend Carol Paddock's faith, because I will be quarantining for the senior following week. Okay? So, anyway, but everything's fine. Okay, and so any other announcements?
We will be decorating the church for Christmas on December 1st.
Okay.
And we need as much help as we can get.
Okay. December 1st.
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock.
In the morning.
Okay. And in the evening or in the morning?
Morning.
Okay.
I'm
all right.
Tonight.
All right. Okay. Any other announcements? Okay, we will now have our call to worship.
Call to worship this morning is from Psalm 107, verse 1. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. And back to Psalm 7, verse 17. I will praise the Lord according to his righteousness, and will sing to the name of the Lord Most High. Let us pray. Almighty and gracious Father, we give you thanks for the fruits of the earth and their season, and for the labors of those who harvest them. Make us, we pray, faithful stewards of your great bounty for the provision of our necessities and the relief of the labors of those who need us. To the glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord, and those that reign with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Thank you.
lesson today is Leviticus, chapter 22, verse 29 to 33. And when you offer a sacrifice of thanksgiving to the Lord, offer it of your own free will. On the same day it shall be eaten, and you shall leave none until morning. I am the Lord. Therefore you shall keep my commandments and perform them. I am the Lord. You shall not profane my holy name, and I shall be hallowed among the children of Israel. I am the Lord who sanctifies you, who brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God. I am the Lord. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Okay, we now have the time of sharing our joys and our concerns. Are there any joys to be shared this morning? Like a vaccine, several of them on the way. It'll be interesting to see how that plays out. That's a joy. An achievement. Okay. Any other joys anybody would like to express? Okay. Hey. Fine. That's good. How many people enjoyed last Sunday with loving you? That was one lot of fun, wasn't it?
Yes.
Okay, any other joy? Anybody concerns you'd like to lift up? Robert Boyd. What now?
The car is headed across the street from us in the car.
Okay. Shirley Huggins' family. Okay.
James Lively passed away. Her parents were Andy and Emmanuel Lively. She was a member of the church.
Okay. Their West family. Any others? Joe Stanley. Is he on the prayer list?
Yes.
Joe. Mark?
Okay.
Is it on the same?
Any others? Any unspoken requests? We'll now have our call to prayer. Thanks to you for all your many blessings, dear God. Dear God, we are so, so very thankful for life and for all that you've done for us throughout the years, throughout history. The blessings of life, the blessings of your Son, Jesus Christ, his life, death, and resurrection, and the hope that we have in the resurrection, eternal life with you forever, dear God. Dear God, this morning, we pray for our world, we pray for our country, we pray, dear God, for this pandemic situation to be resolved. We pray for healing throughout this world and the land. Dear God, we pray that all that is going on will draw us closer to you and help us to point our hearts towards you, dear God, and help us live our lives in such a way to be steadfast in our faith. Let others, dear God, who are facing questions and anxiety and doubts about what life is all about, the fear, that they will come to understand that there's no reason to fear if we live our life power of the resurrection, and the power of your Holy Spirit dwelling in us, dear God, and help us to take this message to the world, dear God, in a good way, Father, in a loving way, in a winsome way. And dear God, we pray this morning for those lifted up in prayer and need a special touch from you. So many folks in our church or our community are shut-ins. And dear God, they're facing very difficult situations physically, dear Father. Dear God, we pray that you would heal them. We pray that you would comfort them, dear God. Dear God, help us in our prayers and our calling and talking with them, dear God, to minister to them and let them feel the presence and the power of God in our lives and in their life in a one-working way, dear Father. Dear God, we thank you for the young people in our church and in our community. And help us to always be mindful, dear God, to live our lives in such a way that they too will grow up to be Christians, dear God, and to know that they are loved by God, and know that there's hope in this world, and this world can be a better place. This helped us to participate with you. Put our hand in your hand, dear God, and let you lead us and be our good shepherd and be good shepherds to the rest of this world, dear Father. Dear God, today as we give our offering, dear God, help us remember that our offering, the most important thing, is our thanksgiving and our heart that we give in a cheerful way. And that's part of our worship, dear Father. So, dear God, be with us and guide us in all that we do in that area. And now, Father, we pray that your Holy Spirit will be with us and abide with us service as we talk about thanksgiving and give us thankful hearts and open hearts, dear God, to hear your word. And now, Lord, we all pray together the prayer that you taught us to pray, the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day
our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
New Testament lesson, 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, verse 15. For all things are for your sake, that grace having spread through the many can cause thanksgiving to abound to the glory of the Lord. Speaking to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things to God the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Word of God for the people of God.
Well, here we are, Sunday before Thanksgiving. Each year, I try to approach it in a different way, maybe perhaps shed some light on different